The whole idea consists of designing the product and the production process at the same time. The concept of simultaneous design is presented in the Advanced Product Quality Planning, APQP manual, which provides guidelines for creating a product and process. How does it work? Everything starts with planning, in which it is defined what will be the subject of the design, what functions the product has to fulfill, and who will be the recipient. When the concept is generally defined, parallel works on the product and process concept begins. It is the moment when the project team should reach for a tool called FMEA and use it on two levels. Product creating the design FMEA, DFMEA, and the process developing the process FMEA, known as PFMEA. In accordance with the scheme proposed by the APQP manual, it is the simultaneous designing that gives the biggest profits. It is based on the assumption that we perform two FMEA analyses in parallel. In further design stages, according to the APQP concept, process and product validation appears, and the whole process ends with the approval of the production process and the product for production. In the next part, we will focus on DFMEA and PFMEA. What are the differences between them? The goal of the DFMEA is to identify weak points in the product. Its task is to find and then limit or eliminate the causes, which can reduce reliability, prevent operation, make it difficult to mount, or even cause loss of a function. What kind of causes can they be? They can be, for instance, a poorly selected material, too wide tolerances, or a lack of environmental protection. In the case of process FMEA, or PFMEA, the goal is to identify those production factors that may lead to a product non-compliance with the design requirements, which have been de facto defined, among others, by the DFMEA analysis. The example may be the omission of manufacturing operations, the installation of incorrect components, or failure of the machines to meet the set temperature parameters. In order to understand how it looks like in practice, let's go back for a moment to the component that was analyzed within the first part of the FMEA material. In other words, the brake disc. In the case of everyday vehicles, the temperature range of these parts is 0 to 350 degrees Celsius. Therefore, the material of the brake disc is very important in this situation. If it had been incorrectly or insufficiently defined at the design stage of the product, it would have been a design failure and therefore related to the design. The analysis of this type of failure is the DFMEA speciality. However, accidental use of a wrong material in the factory and preparation of product batches from it would be already a production failure, which in turn is the subject matter of the PFMEA analysis. In both cases, the effect would be the same. And now it's time for a short task. You can see six cases of irregularities on the screen. On the basis of your knowledge, try to put them to one of two categories, design or process. The problem considered is design failure or process failure. Improper diameter after turning operation. Too high tolerance of the hole position. The lack of definition of a product's corrosion protection. Paint sags on the finished product. Ragged edges. Too low material yield strength defined. Stop the video for 1 minute and then press play to check your answers. Great, I see that you're ready for a summary. So, let's start with design failures. They are the lack of definition of a product's corrosion protection, too high tolerance of the hole position, too low material yield strength defined. If we talk about process failures, they are improper diameter after turning operation, ragged edges, paint sags on the product, As you have probably noticed, the failures in the product design stage will become very quickly visible during the production stage. That is why the key to success is to understand all the requirements that a product has to meet. How to do that? Thanks to the parameter diagram, we are able to define inputs, outputs, control factors, noise factors, and error states. In the central point of the diagram, there is an object to be analyzed. Considering all five aspects, we should be able to gather knowledge about the requirements, risks, and functions. Inputs and outputs describe the flow of energy through our object. They allow us to understand the interactions that occur in the system in which our part is to function. The main function of the brake system, of which the brake disc is a part, is to transfer the force from the brake caliper to the wheel. We do this to reduce the speed of the wheel, which will cause the vehicle to stop. A side effect, and therefore an unwanted element, is the heat release. Control factors are the parameters that are influenced by us. It can be the type of material, its hardness, thickness, depth, or height of the designed object. Failure to do this will lead to failure to perform the basic function. In other words, no possibility of mounting. Noise factors affect the operation of our object, which are beyond our control. Its appearance may cause limitations of certain functions, malfunction, or reduced reliability, leading to premature wear and tear of the system. It can be an external environment. In other words, humidity, road pollution, salt. The changes during use, for example, gradual reduction of the thickness due to abrasion of the disc surface. Normal variation between parts, understood as dimensional variation within tolerance. The way of use by the customer, for example, overheating of brake discs caused by severe braking. And interaction with other parts, such as the effect of an unbalanced wheel on brake disc pulsation. The last element of the P diagram are error states, which may affect the mountability, functionality, and safety. In the case of our example, this can be premature wear and tear, inability to mount, change in braking force over time, or the aforementioned heat release effects leading to overheating of the brake disc.